Hello everyone, and welcome to another Joypad video with me, Mike, aka Dinosaur, here to do another music reaction for you guys. So I'm going to be doing the new August Burns Red track, which is called Paramount, which will be on their upcoming album, I forget what it's called, Guardians? Is that it, Guardians? Yeah, Guardians. So August Burns Red is a band that I got into late in their career. People tell me that Messengers and Constellations are their best albums. I hear Rescue and Restore is their best album. I have not listened to any of those, to be honest with you. I've listened to Found in Faraway Places. That is the album that really got me into August Burns Red, and Phantom Anthem was also very, very good. I haven't delved into their earlier discography, but from what I've heard of the band, and, you know, this is just my personal opinion, which I'm sure I will be attacked for, I feel like every song, if I've heard one song by them, I've heard all of them. Their songs are very samey to me, which, of course, it's the kind of thing where if you like their sound and you like what they do, that's not a problem for you, which, you know, that's how it is with any band. You know, it doesn't. If you like their sound, you like their sound. They don't have to change anything. A lot of bands have built their sound off of releasing the same kind of sounding things over and over again. For example, in my opinion, Breaking Benjamin does that. You know, I don't think they've evolved that much, but they're still very successful with their sound. So that's where I'm at with Breaking Benjamin. That's where I'm at with August Burns Red. I think they're very talented musicians. Jake is a great vocalist. I love the guitars from JB and Brent. Like, they're a very talented band, but I don't know. I feel like their music is kind of samey. Like, listening to Phantom Anthem, the first couple songs are like, yeah, and then it's just a lot of the same sounds, same cut type of riffs. But that's enough of me talking. Let's get into the song, shall we? Right over here. It's just that very straightforward driving metalcore. China.
Yeah.
So I'm pausing a couple things. One, hopefully I won't get, like, you know, a copyright strike or, you know, get the video claimed completely by YouTube, even though I'm not making money off of this. It's good. Again, I don't have a problem with this band, and I think the fact that I haven't listened to them in quite a long time, like, the song just sounds good. The mixing is a little weird. The low end, and it might just be my headphones, this is a gaming headset, it's not meant for, like, phenomenal sound clarity, but the low end feels like it's kind of cranked up, but it doesn't have clarity. Like, the bass drums feel high in the mix, the bass feels high in the mix, but it still sounds kind of muddy. I don't know, but, you know, it might just be me, but it feels a little like it could be cleaned up to make everything pop a bit more. It sounds a little, yeah, it just sounds a little muddy. Also, the vocals right in this part I'm at, where there's this, you know, obviously the screams above, it sounds like there's cleans underneath it. You can't see my hand. So, screams up here. Cleans, like, layered underneath it quietly, or cleans underneath it quietly. It sounds really good. Yeah, it's just a song that kind of gets you, like, pumped, which for me is bad. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. I should be asleep, but, you know, here I am. Let's listen to the rest of the song. Good shredding in there. Kind of like tapping. Good. Yeah. And I think, so I know there's a whole lot of debate on whether or not August Burns Red are a Christian band or not. I don't want to get into that because the band themselves are kind of like flippy-floppy on that issue. But what I think I really like about them in general, first of all, great, like, pump-up music. Like I said, it really just kind of gets you amped. The other thing that I really like, though, is that along with being, like, great pump-up music, it's also kind of very uplifting. Particularly, I remember from Phantom Anthem, The Frost, that's a song that a friend and I called, what, you know, the guitar style, and they do a lot of tapping, but it's like, I'm not good enough at music theory to say if it's, like, done in a major scale, but maybe the mode that it's in, it's very uplifting, and we call it the happy tappy. August Burns Red does a lot of the happy tappy, where it feels like, you know, it's this heavy music, but it's also, it's like motivational and uplifting, whereas a lot of heavier music is kind of like, oh, like, it's got this kind of downtrodden, more melancholy feel to it, where with August Burns Red, you don't really get that. It's very, like, it's motivating, kind of. It makes you feel good, which I think is really cool for this genre of music. Killswitch Engage sometimes gets into that territory, but nowhere near as much as August Burns Red does, which is really cool. It's like a little niche that it's like metalcore that makes you feel good without feeling like angry or sad or depressed, and I really like that about them. So yeah, this is a really good song, and I think, again, I'd have to hear the rest of the album, because hearing this song is like, yeah, I like this song. And if the rest of the album sounds like this song, I'll like the album, but I'll kind of be disappointed in the lack of diversity. But for now, hopefully optimistic. It's a good song. I hope, you know, I do it justice. I hope you like it. Let me know what you think about it. But yeah, thumbs up. It was a good one. I was kind of surprised by how much I liked it, to be honest. Cool. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you like the song. Hope you like my opinion. If you don't, that's fine. Opinions are like, well, you know how that saying goes. Everyone's got one. You can check out all the other stuff I do on my channel. Music reviews every couple days. Gaming content every day. Yeah. Like, comment, subscribe. Give me your thoughts. Tell me your deepest fears. All that stuff. Also check out the podcast my friends send you. It's called The Role Less Taken. It's an actual play RPG podcast where we don't play Dungeons & Dragons. We're currently in the midst of an Apocalypse World campaign. It's a lot of fun. Search for The Role Less Taken. Role is spelled R-O-L-E. Wherever you find podcasts, and you will find us. That's it. Currently in the midst of a global pandemic, so just keep calm, be cool, be smart, be safe. Most importantly, be kind and wash your hands, all right? I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.